Hey everyone, Scott here, Category1Games.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at Scrye number 8. This is a Magic 4th edition prices, Rage Checklist, Jihad poster, free game cards inside for Redemption and Jihad. They're still trying to push Redemption this time. Ice Age prices, oh my goodness, a free Jihad pack? Probably because they knew they were changing the name to Vampire and they had all this dead vampires. Jihad inventory that they couldn't get rid of, so they gave it away, hoping you would stick around with them as they changed the name. Check out this beautiful drawing for Ice Age. I just love things like this. So we are past this in Inquest. In fact, we're almost at, where are we at? We're almost to, what's the same set? Mirage or so in Inquest. So we've got to catch up on Scrye. I apologize. I would have done them more back and forth. But we actually found a huge stack of early Scryes that we didn't know we had. That's what happens when you are a big collector and you buy things without fully knowing. Look at this Shadowfist pullout ad from the cover. Crazy. So they were really pumping this game at the time. Let me try to move this over so it's more centered here on the camera. All right. Ultimate comeback. Like a kick to the head. It's knocking over everyone. I don't remember that game at all. That might be the first time I've seen like an ad for it. First Strike, Umbra. This looks like Scry's editor's message. Let's see, Tempest of the Gods, a collectible card game of epic proportion. So epic that you had never heard of it. Shadow Fist, here's your guide to what's happening in this magazine. So far, we've got a lot of ads. I mean, think if you look back at my old Scry videos of issues 3 and 4, what a vast difference between that and, what is this, issue 8. So just in like 4 to 6 months, they have improved so much in their design and their quality. And their, I mean, they're printing envelopes that people send in with art. This is such a Wizard and Inquest thing to do. You can tell Inquest had a huge impact on them, where they're like, oh crap, we're losing audience to Inquest. We've got to figure out how to be cool like them. So they really made the pages nice. Like, this is an armory. I mean, they're a long time ago Magic seller. And I don't know if they're still big now. They're not one of the big names you hear about now, but definitely were around for a long time and early on. Ice Age Sealed Deck Tournament Report. So here's what's crazy. Is this came out in July, August 1995. I was 14 years old. I went to the Ice Age Sealed Deck release at my local game store, which was a store in the mall that was just one of those carts in the middle of the aisles, and he sold Magic off of it. And so he rented out one of the empty spaces in the mall one Saturday and just held this huge Sealed Deck tournament. And I remember getting the vampire that's like the Singer vampire, but weaker, the Ice Age version, and a few other cards. And I remember playing and just loving it and loving Ice Age and just had such a fun time. I was 14 years old. Magic was like so cool back then. Anyways, really a lot of fun. Wizard of the Coast news. Okay, Homelands, the next expansion set for Magic the Gathering, is coming in 2 shipments, 1 in October and 1 in November. The 8-card booster packs will sell for $1.75. Hidden away by a mysterious wizard for generations, blah, blah, blah. WotC will have a new edition of the Magic the Gathering Pocket Player's Guide, blah, blah, blah. In September, the suggested list price of 4th edition Ice Age and Chronicles increasing Star Decks go from $8.95, booster packs to $2.95, and Chronicles $2.45. Increase in paper prices, printing costs, and the dramatic fall in the U.S. dollar in the international market were cited by WotC as the reasons. Even as a new price, these cards will still be cheaper than Star Trek and Star Wars CCG cards. Interesting. So they're trying to stay cheaper than their competition, as those two games were two of the bigger ones coming after them. Decipher, they released Star Trek Next Generation, Unlimited, and a Warp Pack. Let's see here. I'm looking to see what else is coming out. So, interesting, they still want to be cheaper. So, this is other information like card collectors, Guardians, Decipher, talking about AU coming up, Star Wars in October, it was actually like November, Q in Fall of 95, and Holodeck Adventures in December 95. Ha! That didn't come out for years later, fools. Nah, just kidding. It's funny, that was supposed to be an early expansion, and they obviously waited, what was that, second to last full expansion for the game. convention calendar. It gave you different conventions, net chat. So what was happening, you know, what was popular on the internet, like a Usenet group. I got on the internet in 96 and I never heard of Usenet until I was an adult. Obviously I was missing out on something. Fan made cards. These are always kind of funny. Like here's a Gorn for Star Trek. You've got Riker syndrome. That's funny. God Mask of Egypt. Oh, I hope that player, I hope C. McLulvor is still into Magic and is enjoyed Omniket. Here's other cards that people came up with, like Thalid on a mountain. Anyways, it's kind of funny what people do. Wyvern Phoenix expansion. That's a cool actually ad. It's too bad Wyvern just wasn't that great of a game. Blood Wars. If you love looking back at old history of strategy and cards, this is definitely a magazine for you. Official licensed product, POG, the World POG Federation. They had a POG Federation. I hope that lasted longer than POGs did. Ha! The interesting thing is I was in Tennessee at this time, and I flew out to Arizona, and POGs were big in Tennessee. I flew out to Arizona to visit some family in the Phoenix area, and it had died there. It had been popular. You went to any game or card store, and they just had these things of POGs just discounted beyond belief. I mean, more than spinners are now, right? And so when I went back to Tennessee, I told all my friends, you guys have got to sell your POGs. It's going to die. And they were like, no way, man. POGs are like life. POGs forever. And they wouldn't sell them. And so what happened? They were stuck with them. You know, it's just funny. All right, Paul and Judy's coins and cards. This is so interesting. Look at the pricing. Arabian Nights, $6 or $65 a pack. Set, $695. Antiquities, $875 a box. The Dark, $289 a box. Legends, $875. Fallen Empires, $44.50 a box. Ice Age Call. Anyways, crazy to think of pricing. Like, here's other games and their pricing here. Just so fascinating. I mean, you can kind of see. Star Trek was $159. Unlimited is $55. I mean, you can get those as cheap as around $6 a box if you really keep your eyes on it. Shipping is more expensive than the box are now. Here's the price guide. So Scry got the prices pretty quick. The Battle Begins Ice Age. This is their first pricing for Ice Age. Nope, this is an ad. National Collector. Interesting. So they just list pricing. In Sarasota, Florida. Interesting. So I guess they are a store that was selling, right? Deflection, $15. Can you believe that? What was Icy? Icy Manipulator. They don't even have Icy Manipulator on here. How about Jester's Cap? 35. Jester's Mask, 35. My goodness. Can you imagine paying that? Alpha Beta. Electrifying Source for Gaming Cards. Boom, boom. Thunder and Lightning Cards International. Darby's Den. Summon Savings Tied to 37 more on your gaming needs. Man, I'm going to go buy from the store that has a Magic card looking thing. Magic the Gathering, 1-800-900-GAME, free shipping. Interesting. So this is an interesting term. Multiversal Trading Company. Never heard of them. Out of Hollywood, California. So this is all the pricing. You know, we looked at these other Scryes and they had the huge like retailer section. And they had more info before they got to the price guide. As I said earlier, I think that they were getting hurt by Inquest and realized they needed to get more on the price guide thing. Your Sorcerer Chronicled, Vampire, Everway, 1-800-2-MAGIC-6. That's funny that people are changing their phone numbers to include Magic. Decipher, Magic, Out of Print, Dark Legends, Boxes, Magic the Gathering Singles, Alpha Beta, Ice Age, $109 probably for a box, I hope. Here's Star Trek pricing. These cool life counters. Card Watch, Doom Trooper, Heartbroken, Wyvern. Let's see here. Supernova pricing, Inquisition, Heartbreakers Inquisition on Doom Trooper. You know, they didn't have, you know, one cool thing about Inquest is they had the contest. Here's Jihad pricing. You know, they had, Inquest had cool contests where people were like signing up to do these cool contests, and I don't think Scry ever did contests. I don't think their employees want to do the work that Inquest probably did. Inside Carta Mundi. Okay, so this is a company that printed Magic cards, right? So here's like how the printers work, how they start out. Skids of Uncut Magic, the Gathering sheets. They go on running presses, not so close up, poured footings. This is interesting. Damaged cards are waiting their turn to go into the Shredder. Shredded Magic, the Gathering. Now, supposedly early on in Magic's production cycle, people were coming and grabbing cards out of the damage section before they went into the Shredder, and people were taking and selling those from Cartamundi, and eventually were found out and were fired for it. So it's really interesting how the duelist convocation affects the value of your collection. So here's alpha price comparison with banned cards. Average rare value, average price less discounted rares, Demonic Attorney, Dark Pack Contract from below. So it's showing you early spreadsheet stuff, you know, of charts of how this looks. That's really interesting. I'm sure this article is interesting for back then, and I'm sure it still applies to some degree now. Hyberian Gates, this is basically the whole rules for it. And that's one thing interesting about Inquest, is they basically just printed the rule book for a game. So like, here's Overpower, the rules of Overpower and how to play. It was cool seeing the artwork and learning how to play a game. But if you just bought a starter, you basically learn the same thing, right? Here's Vampire. So obviously, Jihad had changed its name to Vampire at this point. So even though you got a free Jihad pack in here, they already knew that they were changing to Vampire. So, and I wonder if saying that name is why some of my videos have been demonetized by YouTube, is because I'm saying Jihad and they're viewing that as like something bad versus like the name of a card game. I bet you money that's what it is. So I've been having some of my videos demonetized because IdQuest views them as adult and not friendly to kids, which is hilarious because there's nothing I've shown that's not friendly to kids except for maybe the Austin Powers game, which is like PG-13 or above, right? Oh, that's too funny. So you see all these different card games. I mean, it's interesting to me, like Star Quest, Tempest of the Gods. I mean, so many people are coming out with card games. You know, like, here's this one. It looks like comic book art, bad comic book art, and I'm sure it just failed. It didn't even get made. Who knows? Here's Guardians Introduction, how to win, how to play. Like, Gridiron, just terrible. Just terrible. Ultimate Combat, like I said, I don't even think that game got made, but really, this Scrye has spent some time on it. Warlords, you know, some of these games actually did get made, most of them didn't. And it was just a total glut of CCGs during this time period. Okay, so here's the Regional Advisor's Retail Market Reports. I always find these probably the most interesting to see, like, where they come from. Like, here's Nevada. This is Asgard Games. Talking about 4th edition. We're pleased to announce that it sells extremely well, 4th edition. This is due to no small part of the inclusion of several previously rare expensive cards from other expansions. It's great to see players get these cards out of the packs, remove some of the rich kid syndrome from the game. Our packs of the 4th edition sell as quickly as we get them in. The re-releases cards such as Carrion Ants, Killer Bees, Spirit Link, and Colossus caused an absolute panic in the speculators market. However, our victory over outrageous prices was short-lived since WotC removed Dual Lands, Fork, and Versuvian Doppelganger. I guess that was a fair compromise. Ice Age, I'm simply amazed at this most recent release. Art is the best to date. The players all love it, and Ice Age has brought fun back to the game. We held a tournament on the first weekend that Ice Age was available. It was great to see players having to read each other's cards so they knew what was going on. The tourney took forever due to everyone's unfamiliarity with the new cards, but who cares? It's truly a new separate game. Now, you've got to realize during this time period, people played Magic for fun. And they showed up to an event, and that event was the first time you saw these cards. You didn't have it spoiled online. You didn't have a magazine spoiling it for you. This was truly the first time you saw it, and you didn't have time to strategize what you're going to do. I mean, that article sums up how much fun Magic was back then, where you open that starter of Magic, and you're like, Snow Cover Lands, what? That's so cool. Or like, you know, whatever card you got was just like the neatest thing because it was the first time you saw it. And then you open the packs, you're like, what's my rare? Oh, man, so cool. And now Magic is just not the same. Any card game is not the same. You see it all online. The spoiling of card games has ruined it to me. And takes away so much of the fun that you used to have back then. And I don't know if people could have that fun now or have a set come out and not know what it was beforehand without them whining and complaining about it. It's just sad to me. This guy from Magic Source. Ice Age is the big news this month. What's there to say? The art is awesome and the cards are awesome. The whole set is really cool. Wizards of the Coast is also fostering this sentiment by having Ice Age only tournaments. Since tournaments have typically been the driving force behind playstyle, this will make Ice Age only decks much more popular. It's true. It was an interesting time for retailers and for players. You know, it was really cool. Because Magic, WotC was thinking about just having Ice Age only events and not having like rotations, which they eventually settled on the next block, but just having it like be a whole separate game. Anyways, this is Scott, Category 1 Gates. I hope you've enjoyed this look back at Scry number 8 with me. I know I've had fun looking back and good memories, funny memories seeing these games that just didn't take off. Anyways, thanks for joining us. Look for us next week as we take a look at another Scry. We'll stay with Scrys until we can get our Inquest caught up with us, or we can get through these till we're match up with Inquest. Thanks, everyone. Category1Games.com.